Jay Haynes for the Film Sensei channel. Today in this video, we're going to do this melting letters effect in HitFilm Express. If you like these kinds of videos with these tutorials and tips and tricks, do me a favor and subscribe to the channel and click that little bell icon for notifications. So before we actually do the melting letters, let me show you the technique that happens behind it. I'm going to start by creating a new composite shot, click OK, and I am just going to add a new plane layer, clicking OK, and then I'm going to duplicate that plane, click, and I do that by Control D. The top plane I need to be white, and the bottom plane I need to be black, so I'm just going to put a fill color effect here on the top plane. And just for demonstration purposes, I'm going to create a couple of masks that I will move towards each other and away from each other to see how that they melt against each other. So there are actually three ways of doing this, and I'm going to show you my favorite way. However, the other two ways have benefits of their own. One of them even allows you to mix colors. And so I will, for the green belts in my Patreon dojo, my green belt supporters, I will give a project file to you that will show you the other two ways that will completely explain it, and also will have examples for you. What I'm going to do is create a grade layer, and in that grade layer, I'm going to put two effects. I'm going to first start with a blur effect, dropping that in there. You see, it makes everything sort of fuzzy, right? And if I adjust the blur, it makes it fuzzier. And then the second effect I'm going to use is a threshold effect that will draw a hard line on that blur. But here's the beautiful thing about it. Let me go back to this and grab one of these two planes. And if I slide this one towards the other one, now you can see it sort of melts together, right? So this is one of the ways that you can create this sort of melting effect. You need the plane below it, that black plane. If it is not there, then this technique will not work. However, one of the other techniques doesn't need a black plane, so there can be a sort of transparency that happens there. And again, that'll be in the project file that I provide for my Patreon green belts. So having demonstrated the technique, let me now show you how to do the melting effect. First thing I'm going to do is get rid of this plane, and I'm going to add instead some text. And I'm not going to type in anything particular. Hint, hint. Just think about that, though. As I sit here and type it, I will go ahead and make it bigger so that you can see it. And also, I'm just stretching it out a little bit there. Hint, hint. Okay, I'm going to take this, and I am under the, we'll zero out the blur. We'll slide that down. Now, notice that when I up the radius, it starts to melt it away. Okay, so there it is. It's that simple. Oh, you know what I should do? Let's make it bolder. Yeah, there we go. Okay. All right, so now there are going to be three things that I need to do. And first I need to start by adding another plane, because I do need a plane that is white underneath it. And that plane that is white underneath it, this is going to be where it sort of melts into, okay? So again, I want to use a fill color effect to melt that in. But I also want it to be sort of round, so I'm just adding an elliptical mask to it. You just double click on that elliptical mask and it adds it right on there. Okay. All right, so now back to my grade layer. If I start upping the radius, you can see how that's going to sort of melt together. And ultimately, I want it to be about, you know, that much melted maybe. So I'm just going to come out here to the back end and hit that, so you can see where that is, and then I will just take that back down to zero. Okay, so that's the first thing that I want to have happen. Okay, as this is melting, though, I want this white plane to appear. So under the transform properties of the plane, in fact, let me come back out to the radius and just come to about there. What I want to do is under the transform properties, I want to go ahead and click that scale. And then if I back up, I want that to be zero. Okay, so it's gone, and then it sort of appears right, as that happens. Now, the only other thing is that I want these letters to drop into that area. So this new text here, let me just come to here, and I'm just going to have it the position of that fall down a little bit and come back here, maybe make this zero. So now as I watch this, they sort of are falling, and they're definitely not in sync. So here's what I'm going to do. There is a special key in HitFilm that you can use to look at keyframes, and it's called the U key. If I hit the U key, now you can see all of the keyframes that I have made. First thing I'm going to do is just go ahead and make these into manual bezier, just so they're a little smoother, okay? And then I'm going to start moving some of these keyframes a little bit here, because I want this one to be later, because I want this, this is moving too quick. So I'm just going to start, that is also appearing too fast. So I want this, and what I'm going to need is this to drop faster. So I'm just playing with these until, that's pretty close. That's not bad. Hold on. So now it is dropping. Oh, and it's just melting. But I'm not fond of how it just keeps dropping. So I'm just going to pull these back. And I do want to extend this out here. So now it's just, except that I need this thing to get bigger quicker. Let me just grab this one like this, so, but I don't need it to appear until this drops faster, right? So, there we go. Look at that. And so you're just sort of playing with this effect until it's right, okay? You just sort of mess with these keyframes until they feel like they belong in where they are, okay? And there it is, right? And you can really play with that as much as you want it to, okay? Just making adjustments along the way. But basically, in a nutshell, this is the basics and the idea of how to melt letters in HitFilm Express. So if you have any questions, anything you want answered, just put them in the comments below. I'll be happy to answer them for you. Otherwise, thanks for watching.